Today we're going to talk about an infamous incident in Beatles history, the time George Harrison's guitar fell off their touring car and was run over by multiple trucks. Why is this important? Well, I have two interesting details I'd like to point out in this video. First, that I believe we've been wrong about a critical detail for decades. And second, that another Beatles guitar thought to be destroyed might still be out there. The key players in this story are two of George Harrison's primary Gretsch guitars, the Tennessean and the Country Gentleman. Although neither of these instruments was ever seen again after November 1965, it's generally considered by Beatles historians that the Country Gentleman was the one destroyed. However, I'm not so sure that's true. Here's the story. Going back to December 2nd, 1965, the Beatles are just about to start their final tour of the UK, so this is what we know. The Beatles chauffeur, Alf Bicknell, is driving the band in their Austin Princess with 14 guitars strapped to the roof. They're heading to Glasgow, Scotland on the M1 motorway when they are flashed to stop their vehicle by a truck behind them. In Keith Badman's book, The Beatles Off the Record, Alf Bicknell recounts the story. Now I'm going to summarize, but I'll post a link to the full segment in the description. I went back to this great big articulated vehicle, and the driver said to me, "I think you've dropped a banjo back down the road." I went back to my car, and Neil Aspinall and I just stood there looking, noticing the straps were broken. There were two guitars there, but now there was only one. So I went round the car and said, "I think we've lost the guitar." We got back in the car, and we got to the end of this 12-mile stretch of motorway. There was nothing. We started finding little bits of wood and then a guitar string. We ended up with a little piece of the guitar each. In the same book, George Harrison also recalls the event with some slightly different details. 14 of our guitars were strapped to the roof of our Austin Princess, and the only one lost was my Gretsch. It fell onto the road and into the path of oncoming traffic. About 13 lorries went over it before the chauffeur could get near it. Then, one of the lorries stopped and the driver came up with the dangling remains of it and said, "Oi, is this banjo anything to do with you?" Okay, so now let's do some detective work. I dug up an old copy of the Glasgow Herald from December 4th, 1965. This would be right after the Beatles' performance there the night before. So have a look at this article. George Harrison appeared at last night's show with a hastily borrowed guitar after his own had been run over by a lorry when it fell from the boot of their car on the A1 near Berwick-on-Tweed. "My special favorite, smashed to bits," he bemoaned at a news conference before the show. He added that when they found the remains of the guitar, it looked as if it had been run over by about 10 lorries. "It's out of tune now," quipped John Lennon. "Yeah, no shit, John." Here's another article, this time with Neil Aspinall, documenting the tour day by day. We're on our way to Scotland. A lorry driver has just told us that a guitar dropped out of the boot a few miles back. We turn and we start searching the road, Alf's headlights full up so that we don't miss anything. 30 minutes are wasted before we come across the debris of the guitar. Fragments are scattered all over the place. "It's not the 12-string," says George, sounding very much relieved. "It's not my bass, is it?" asks Paul. "No, my spare Gretsch," replies George, holding up a few inches of splintered wood and tangled strings. It could have been worse. The Gretsch was not one of the guitars George needed on stage, although it was one which he was particularly fond of for practicing. And so as it happened, that fragment which we picked up came in handy. It included the machine head of the instrument, the metal screws used to tighten and tune the strings. When part of Paul's machine head broke during the tour, we were able to replace it with bits taken from George's broken Gretsch. Now I want you to remember that last detail about the tuner. It's very important, and I'm sure some of you Beatle fans are already going to know where I'm going with this. Now this brings us to Kenneth Womack's new Mal Evans biography, Living the Beatles Legend, The Untold Story of Mal Evans. And I'm sure most fans already know this, but Mal was basically the Beatles' combination roadie, bouncer, equipment manager, etc. So check out this segment. As it turned out, the spare Country Gentleman had fallen off the back of the limo a few miles back, while Alf was driving the Princess through a particularly bumpy patch of road. A distraught George looked on in disbelief as Alf and Neil gathered up bits of the destroyed guitar along the motorway. Ironically, the stray pieces of broken guitar came in handy a few days later. When Paul broke one of the machine heads on his Hofner violin bass, Mal was able to use the spare parts from the ruined Country Gentleman to make the repairs. Aha! Okay, so the Gretsch Country Gentleman was destroyed, right? Cool. End of story, end of video, right? Well, not exactly. So I think this story has been misremembered and repeated so many times that the details have become hazy over the years. Paul McCartney's long-lost Hofner violin bass was recently found and returned to him, and if you want to hear about that story, check out the link to my video in the description. With the return of this bass, we finally have a chance to look at close-ups of its condition, which is why many Beatles fans were surprised to see this. Something doesn't belong here. What is that tuner doing there? And I know what you're thinking, this instrument was missing for decades, so surely that tuner could have been added later, right? So this is a perfect example of it was right in front of us the whole time. Or rather, we just weren't looking. Not only can we see that Paul's bass has a chrome tuner in the Revolution promo video, we can also see in the Let It Be movie that this very tuner is on the bass. And in this now famous 1965 photo of all the Beatles gear just piled up backstage, just a few days after the incident, by the way, we can see that one of the tuners on the bass is clearly metallic and not plastic. I'm sure there's some psychological reason for why none of us noticed this, but the fact remains, it was there in the 1960s. So what is that tuner? If Mal's story is true, that means this tuner should match the ones on a Country Gentleman. But Gretsch Country Gentleman guitars have distinctive Grover Imperial tuners with gold plating, and this clearly isn't one of them. However, Gretsch Tennesseans have unbranded nickel tuners, often referred to as Waverly tuners. And what do you know? They look to be a pretty perfect match for the ones that are currently on McCartney's bass. So I'll let you be the final judge, but I'll just say what I'm thinking. It was the Gretsch Tennessean that was destroyed, not the Country Gentleman. And as disappointing as that is, knowing that there is another Beatles guitar that is lost forever, it does mean one thing. The Country Gentleman could still be out there, and this would be huge. This is the guitar on the Ed Sullivan Show and so many other live performances. So Beatle fans, start looking.